talk more about Cameroon, where we talk about Magasco and the challenge he had to put up online, and talking about his song Give, which was released not long ago. And Magasco had a challenge online saying that any artist that is going to get into the challenge, that is the Give challenge, was going to feature in a remix of that song with him. And indeed, sometimes humility pays. We are talking about Magasco, who launched this challenge, and it was noticed that just the upcoming artist even made an endeavor to get into this challenge, and the most outstanding artist that everyone least expected him to even pay attention to this was Mike Monster, who got into the challenge. And everyone has actually been shocked, everyone has been surprised, saying that Mike Monster is an example for all the artists in Cameroon to follow. Now, they talk about Tizi Pancha, who had done so and done almost similar stuff when he had the Nassau challenge, where we had artists like Cleo Gray, we had Vivid Smith, we had Very New Tina, and now they have been called household artists in Cameroon just because they had to take part in this challenge, and now they are slowly becoming stars. Cameroon has been noted for minimizing challenges or for supporting their own brother, as looking at Tizi Panchak's Nassau challenge, talking about now a challenge done for us by Magasco, the Give challenge. And let's make a little reference to Kiss Daniel's challenge, which was online, and almost all Nigerian artists were part of this challenge to show that they support each other. So what is actually happening in Cameroon that we cannot support our own brother? Some of us actually, or some of the artists, the A-list artists, they feel like they are just too big enough not to get themselves involved in stuff like this. And now Mike Monster took upon himself, not only because he was concentrated or his main reason for taking part of this was to get into the remix, but he stated clearly that he got into this just to show love, to support Magasco, and to show him that they are one another's keeper and that they are there for each other. This act done by Mike Monster has given him a lot of upper hand on social media. Everyone is yelling Mike Monster and saying that actually Mike Monster, Tizi Panchak, they are good examples to follow, and they have seen an act of humility in the life of Mike Monster and that of Tizi Panchak, and they have been struggling to build an entertainment industry where we love and support each other while helping the upcoming artists to grow. With Tizi Panchak, we can call artists like Cleo Gray, we can talk about Vivi Smith, we can talk about Tina. Now they are making strides and shining everywhere. So now what happens to all the A-list artists like the Daphne's, like the Stanley Enos, and all the like? Is it that maybe they feel that they actually had made it, or they have made it already, and these kind of challenges are actually not for them, just for upcoming artists? And does this actually really portray support in our entertainment industry? That is the question that we all ask ourselves. And now Magasco and Mike Monster, they are already on the remix of that song Give. Now, let's talk about the sad news that we heard today. Cameroon is actually really bereaved, I mean, our entertainment industry, with this fine rapper who was shot dead in Bamenda along Damokong Road yesterday night, and was discovered this morning lying so much dead. And we are saying that indeed it is really a sad and a shocking news, and we are sending out our condolences to the family. We are saying that this boy was actually striving so hard to actually get into the A-list of artists in Cameroon, and no one could actually identify who shot him nor what happened. But the only thing we can say is he was shot last night and was discovered this morning already dead. We say that sometimes it is hard, as much as it is so painful, all we have to say is God gives and God takes. And we are saying that God should give the family a lot of encouragement and strength to be able to hold up during a trying moment like this. Now, let's talk about Mings. Mings actually has been noted for knowing exactly what to do to his fans, knowing exactly what his fans want, and exactly doing just exactly what they want. And not long ago, Mings has been giving a lot of posts on social media, that is riddles and all the humors, and it's actually working for him because it's keeping his fans actually really connected to him. Now, not long ago, Mings goes online to say that Your profile picture on your guy's phone does not mean he loves you, hen. Even flies have their picture on insecticides. He continues with words like, Pepper is no more lucrative. Now everyone is selling body lightening cream. He says, I don't know what is happening these days, but I give my life to Christ and he gives me back. Mings made a remarkable impact on the music scene in 2016 with the explosive hit Legalaile, and he later featured in Blanche Burley's monster hit Mimbaya, which gave him a household name in 2017. His lyrics are satirical and contain effortless humor, and he uses social media to build his fan base and keep them entertained, and knows exactly how to give them exactly what they want, and they keep enjoying it. And it is noted that each time Mings comes online with riddles like this, with humor like this, you know that he's about to release something fresh, and he knows exactly how to keep his company, how to keep his fans glued to him, and then how to keep everything entertainment so much actually humorous. We say that Mings, he knows when it comes to showbiz 237, he knows exactly what people want, and he's always just there to give them exactly what they want. Now, let's talk about Soli Egbe, okay, who have been termed that Soli Egbe has been one of the most outstanding actresses in Cameroon, but it has been noted that this lady has been minimized a lot. She has been undervalued a lot, and per social media grading and everything, it is said that looking at the projects that this lady has actually taken upon herself, she deserves a hot seat in entertainment industry, especially when it comes to movie in Cameroon. The ultra-silk fairling with a smooth glowing complexion has her vitality and competencies in acting and movie production and has been outstanding. Solantine Egbe was born on the 20th of May 1992 and hails from Manu Division, and Soli has starred in Cameroon movies, Nollywood movies, produced and acted in several comedy skits. Her ability to fit in and flow seemingly in any role she's given is simply mind-blowing. She made her cinema debut in 2011, and her aptitude has proven in movies like Shrill, which she produced and starred in, Dark Side, Abashed, Irrevocable Act, Woman, Before You Gain of a Kind Heart, Say Yes, I Do, Bat Runs, The Prodigal Son, Baron, Rumble, the TV series, and Strip. We should be seeing Soli Egbe unbiasedly and casted in more than so many movies in Cameroon. But it is said that this lady actually, when it comes to awards, when it comes to giving all the brand ambassadors and everything, when it comes to movie roles in Cameroon, this lady has been minimized and undervalued. Now it is time for us to judge not just by the physical appearance, no connections, no friendship. Let us not be biased, but let us face the fact and look into the accomplishments of an actor, of an actress, or an artist before giving all the grades. Now, let's talk about Cameroon designer. Not long ago, it was actually made very known on social media that though Cameroon was actually well represented during the Miss Universe contest, our lady Cosinda, who represented Cameroon, could not make it to the finals nor emerge the winner. Not long ago on social media, a designer actually came online to say that his account actually has been hacked, and there is someone claiming that he actually designed the outfits that you could see from Cosinda during the Miss Universe contest. And this guy is saying that he actually did not design all these outfits, and someone actually hacked his account claiming to have designed these outfits. And he claims and says that he has been away from social media for over 6 months now and knows nothing about Miss Universe or her designs. The online force surrounding the original designer of Cosinda Angel's outfits at Miss Universe has been settled. It is now clear it was sketched and tailored by the Filipino designer Kennedy John Gaspar, that is a white and from China, and the Cameroonian designer Julien has disclaimed information on social media, saying he designed the national costume, which was published by an imposter claiming to be Modest Alugo. He says that he is here to clear his name. He cannot take credit for what he did not do. And he's saying that the person that actually the credit should be going to is this Filipino guy. And with name, he says his names are Kennedy John Gaspar. He did all these designs and made this lady, Cosinda, to represent Cameroon at the Miss Universe contest. Let's talk about Sang Dilong. Yes, we have been announcing, talking about Sang Dilong all the weeks and almost a month now, while everyone is expecting that this lady maybe would be seated somewhere, arms folded, and so much sadness, depression, traumatized, and crying about her relationship and marital issues. Well, she has made it upon herself to be distracted and to continue being an entrepreneur. Not long ago, Sang Dilong, you know, she owns a restaurant there in Chang, and it is located directly just around the University of Chang. And not long ago, Sang Dilong crowns Miss Tamana. That is the name of the restaurant, is Tamana. And this lady was once a model, and she has taken upon herself to actually promote modeling, though she had to quit it because she wanted to have a home and to be responsible. And following the name of her restaurant, named Tamana, she decided to do a beauty pageant, a beauty contest, to say that she's looking for a miss that would carry the name of her restaurant. And as you can see, following the pictures, she crowned a miss. And all we can say is, Sang Dilong is a tough lady, and indeed she is an entrepreneur, and she is not weighed down by any emotional troubles nor trauma. She is waxing strong and standing so strong on her business. The first prize here was 100,000 francs, second prize was 75,000 francs, sorry, and the third prize was 50,000 francs. The runner-ups received this money respectively, and what nothing, Sang Dilong was crowned Miss West Africa Cameroon in 2011. And though she's no longer active in the modeling scene, she keeps promoting aspirants. We say that, my lady, sometimes when it comes to business, you have to keep your emotions aside and follow and do exactly what you have to do. Okay? We'll be right back after the little break. Sorry, before we get into that, let's talk about Shakiro. Oh, yes. Shakiro, not long ago, we heard about him being sentenced 5 years, yes, to serve the sentence in jail for practicing immorality and homosexuality in Cameroon. And Shakiro comes out to express a lot of bitterness and anger, as she says that they have jailed me for 5 years, saying that I practice homosexuality as though I stole money from Cameroon government. We have a lot of people here who have stolen and done worse things, but mine has been considered like the most horrible thing I ever did all my life. Now I'm getting much more furious because I'm not the only one in things like this, but the people promoting me and the people who have been doing and taking advantage of my body are keeping silent, and now I am forced to spill out all the things that I am not supposed to say. Shakiro has promised to expose all his homosexual mates and those who have been having sex with him, those he has been having sex with, and to say that he does not deserve to go down just alone, to take the fall alone, because he has other people who have been promoting him, who have been sponsoring him and helping him to act like this. And so in no time, he's actually going to disclose everyone that has been involved in homosexuality when it comes to Shakiro, when it comes to his friend, when it comes to those in Yaoundé, those in Douala. And he says that he knows a lot of people that if he calls the names, you are actually not going to believe that they are involved in scandals like this. But definitely in no time, we are expecting him to actually mention the names of all his promoters and his partners. That was it for our national page. Let's have a break and we'll be right back to get into our international page. Stay with us.